in the last 2 years, we have had 7 of the 20 highest high tides since records began.
We're a pretty flood-resilient city, but there are increasing incidents of flooding. And the key to us is to find ways of responding to those, trying to predict them better and respond better. So with limited resources, we can have a better response.
Our brief is to reduce the existing flooding and look at the future flooding and put defences and mitigating measures in place.
There's a general expectation that we will, one, that we will prevent as far as possible, that we will give people better information as to when they can expect flooding, and that we will have, as good a response when there are actual flooding incidents. So, and that really requires us to have much better information, particularly when it comes to deploying our limited resources.
My name is Emer O'Dolly, and I live in between the Tolka River and the canal in the north inner city. 5 years ago-ish, we had a big flood in the area. It seems that the river had overflowed, and in the middle of the night we could hear water running, and I thought that the water tank was burst or something, and we went out to the kitchen and there was 8-10 inches of water in the whole kitchen. It was completely flooded.
Dublin City Council are working with Intel on a research project on the future of flood management.
It was an agreement between ourselves, Intel and Dublin City Council to explore the new gateways that we've developed. The first aim of the research is to provide good information to the council that they can use for their, to make decisions around flood management.
Intel designs gateways, which are literally small compute platforms that sit at the edge of networks. It allows us to integrate sensors. So for example, working with Dublin, we build environmental sensors and they connect to these gateways. And these gateways are positioned on lampposts, for example. They can be positioned on traffic lights. So it gives us the ability to very quickly capture data, bring that data together, and send that information to the cloud for processing. From a city's perspective, we're capturing various different types of environmental data sources, and then we're providing that information to the city through a portal where they can build on it. So that's what the Internet of Things is all about, the ability to actually react and make a decision.
My name is Roy O'Donnell, I'm the Gully Manager for Dublin City Council. If we had the benefit of hyperlocal data through census throughout the city, we could certainly use it in an instant to know where we can send and deploy our resources to. If we know where the rainfall is hitting at its hardest and at its heaviest, and it's accurate, then we can deploy our resources to those areas, or more of our resources to those areas.
All the challenges that we face, there's an overriding challenge in terms of we operate in a very constrained resource environment. So no matter what we're trying to do, we're trying to do it now smarter ways and with less resources. And the traditional model of just deploying any number of people to deal with problems, that's no longer sustainable. So in an era like flood management, we need to just be a lot smarter so we can get a better return from our more limited resources. I see technology playing a very critical role in terms of the future of all major cities, and Dublin in particular. And if we can work with companies like Intel, it gives us an opportunity to sort of to be at the forefront of technological innovation, something the City Council could never do on its own.